necessary words, use correct grammar. Time for the speech is between 5 and 7 minutes. The speech will be evaluated by Dorian O'Keefe. The title of the speech is this right now, Tom Hiddleston's Bottom.
Correct.
The speaker is Susan McGrady. Would you please welcome Susan to the podium, please?
Wires everywhere. Excuse the mess. Come along. Okay. Rightio. Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Good evening, Mr. President, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Before I begin, I'd like to ask you, do any of you know who Tom Hiddleston is? Okay, some of you do, that's good. By the end of this speech, the rest of you are going to be very familiar with Tom Hiddleston. So, what I want to talk to you about this evening is a subject that's really close to my heart. And it's something that's really quite topical at the moment. I want to talk to you tonight about feminism and gender equality. So, the definition of feminism, as you see there, is the theory of political, economic, and social equality of the sexes. This is also known as gender equality. And number two, organized activity on behalf of women's rights and interests. This is something that I'm passionately involved with. But we'll get back to that in a minute. For a moment, let's get back to Tom Hiddleston. Tom Hiddleston is an English actor. Those of you who know him probably know him best from his sort of breakthrough role playing the troublesome trickster god of mischief, Loki, in the Avengers series, and Thor and those. Tom is also a self-described feminist. So, we'll go back. You're not allowed to know that one yet. So, Tom has received lots and lots of awards, Grammys, Emmys, Empire, you name it, he has won them. But the award that I want to talk to you about tonight, that is my favourite of his awards, is one that he won last year, beating Jamie Dornan, who played Christian Grey in 50 Shades of Grey, to the post, pipping him to the post, to win the accolade of Rear of the Year 2016. Tom won Rear of the Year 2016 for his role in a miniseries called The Night Manager, and he won it for his steamy sex scene that he portrayed very candidly. There he is, Mr. Rear of the Year. So, aside from the fact that he has a very fine bottom, the reason he chose to bare all in this and his next movie, the aptly named Crimson Peak, was right down to his belief in equality. Tom has said that it is so often in movies that women are more naked than men, and that that's unfair. We wanted to redress the balance. I think that's quite admirable. Thank you, Tom. So, when Emma Watson launched the UN's equality campaign, He for She, Tom was one of the first people on board. But he wasn't the last person on board. He and his bottom were joined by a long and distinguished list of male celebrities. We have Barack Obama, the former President of the United States, Benedict Cumberbatch, the lovely Tom, Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister of Canada, Kiefer Sutherland, Patrick Stewart, who is a phenomenal advocate for women's rights, in particular violence against women. Domestic violence is his main thing. We have Jared Leto. These guys are a boy band whose name I don't know, but my kids say they're really good. David Tennant, who is a Scottish actor. And Joss Whedon. Joss is an American director and writer who has written and directed an awful lot of what we've seen in the last 20 years. He's known for writing strong female characters. And one of his strong female characters that he wrote was one of my main role models growing up, from the age of 18 right up until the age of 39 right now, Buffy the Vampire Slayer. He also founded an organization, a charitable organization called Equality Now, whose ambition is to raise awareness and promote equality for women in the United States. Joss gets asked all the time why he writes so many strong female characters. Every time he does an interview, this is the question that comes up. And at an event he did a couple of years ago for Equality Now, he tackled the question. And he gave the answer that on the 11 millionth time that he was asked, "Joss, why do you write such strong female characters?" His final answer was, "Because you're still asking me that question." Meaning, hey journalists, why don't you ask the other guy why he's not writing strong female characters? Women have strength. Moving closer to home, finding Irish male feminists was quite the challenge. Several hours spent on Google yielded only a handful. We have our president, Michael D. Higgins, Hosier, Blind Boy Boat Club from the Rubber Bandits. Will St. Ledger. And Graham Lenehan. Some of whom I hadn't even heard of before I discussed this with friends of mine. And I can't actually 100% vouch that this information that I have is correct, that they are all actually. It was so hard to find information on Irish male role model feminist allies. So the Irish were represented very poorly compared to my previous slide, and I wondered why. Surely equal rights is something that we all believe in. Aren't we all entitled to the same treatment, dignity, and respect as each other? I worry that feminism and feminist has become a bad word. And at a time when the fight for equal rights is brewing up another storm here in Ireland. So what do I want? I want a gender equal world. I want more men standing up in support of equal rights. I want more men walking around in "this is what a feminist looks like" t-shirts as my friends were earlier on. I want to see the he for she hashtag plastered all over walls, both virtual and real. Essentially, what I would like to see in Ireland is more of Tom Hiddleston's bottom. Thank you.